Today we are going to explain addressing the concept of a solution methods for expressing the concentration of a solution. This is our topic, methods for expressing the concentration of a solution. There are different methods to express the concentration of a solution. Among those, number one, weight by weight, volume percentage. Nothing but volume by volume, mass to volume percentage, weight by volume percentage, volume to mass percentage, volume by weight percentage. Strength of solution. PM, PPM, parts per million, and PPB, parts per billion. These are some methods. So today we are going to explain some methods for expression of solution. Among those, volume percentage, mass to volume percentage, volume to mass percentage, strength of solution, and PPM, parts per million, parts per billion. Along these, some other methods. Molarity, Kaplan, Normality, Molality, small m denoted by Mole fraction, Solubility, S. Among all the methods, molality and solubility will give a relation between solute versus solvent. Among all the methods, molality and solubility will give a relation between solute versus solvent. Remaining all the methods will give a relation between solute versus solution. These are some methods to express the concentration of a solution. Molarity, normality, mole fraction, solubility. Among all the methods, molality and solubility will give the relation between solute versus solvent. Remaining all the methods, those will give the relation between solute versus solution. Now, we'll explain one by one. Now we are going to explain mass percentage. Mass percentage. Mass percentage. It is also called as weight by weight percentage. Weight by weight percentage. It is defined as the amount of solute. The amount of solute in grams. The amount of solute in grams present in 100 grams of solution is called as mass percentage or percentage mass. Mass percentage. The amount of solute in grams present in 100 grams of solution is called as mass percentage. Percentage mass is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Percentage mass we can written as mass of solute by mass of solution. Otherwise the same formula we can written as mass of solute by mass of solute plus mass of solvent into 100. The same formula we can written as mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Why? Because the mass of solution is nothing but mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Here volume is equal to mass by density. Volume is equal to mass by density. Whereas mass is equal to volume into density, V into D. Based on this formula, percentage mass is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into density of solution into 100. The same as mass percentage or percentage of mass is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into density of solution into 100. Percentage mass is equal to mass fraction into 100. Percentage mass is equal to mass fraction into 100. What the mass fraction? It nothing but mass ratio. It nothing but mass ratio means what? Mass of solute by mass of solution. It nothing but mass fraction. Then nothing but 100 we have only. Means the same formula, the mass of solute by mass of solution into 100, that is the mass percentage. The same formula we can represent remaining other formulas also. It is about the mass percentage. So that percentage mass nothing but mass of solute by mass of solution. Otherwise, mass of solute by mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Otherwise, mass of solute by volume of solution into density of solution into 100. Otherwise, mass fraction into 100. These are different formulae for calculating mass percentage or weight percentage. We will observe some kind of examples. Example 1. 10% solution. 10% solution of sugar. 10% solution of sugar. What it means? That means it contains 10 grams sugar present in 10 grams sugar present in 100 grams of solution. Here sugar present in otherwise 10 grams sugar present in 90 grams of water, if water is solvent, 90 grams of water. Suppose take the example number 2. Here 20% aqueous solution of Na2CO3, sodium carbonate. 20% aqueous solution of Na2CO3. What means 20 grams of Na2CO3? 20 grams of Na2CO3 solute dissolving and present in 100 grams of solution. Otherwise 20 grams of Na2CO3 present in 80 grams of water. Why? Because they are taken as aqueous solution. Aqueous means water. It is a complete meaning about the percentage mass. Volume percentage. It is defined as the volume of solute in ml. The volume of solute in ml present in 100 ml of solution is called as volume percentage. The volume of solute in ml present in 100 ml of solution means volume percentage or percentage volume is equal to volume of solute by volume of solution into 100. And go for 10% ethanol, ethyl alcohol. 10% ethanol. Ethanol solution. 10% ethanol solution with water can act as solvent. In this case, 10 ml of ethanol C2H5OH ethyl alcohol present in 100 ml of solution. 100 ml of solution. Similarly, the same meaning you can written as 10 ml of C2H5OH present in 90 ml of water. It's nothing but volume percentage. These methods are very, very important while solving the problems later. It's about volume percentage. Number 3, mass to volume percentage means weight by volume percentage. Whatever denominator taken as, that should be 100. Here, mass to volume percentage, the amount of solute in grams. The amount of solute in grams present in 100 ml of solution is called as mass to volume percentage. Here mass to volume percentage is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into 100. And see that 20 weight by volume of Na2CO3 solution if taken as suppose. This is very, very important. 20% weight by volume of Na2CO solution means 20 grams of Na2CO3 sodium carbonate. 20 grams of Na2CO3 is present in 100 ml of solution means indirectly we got the amount of solute and volume of solution. Based on these, we'll do the problems later one by one. Similarly, mass to volume percentage is equal to the amount of solute in grams present in 100 ml of solution. Mass to volume percentage is equal to mass of solute by volume of solution into 100. Here is an example. 20% weight by volume of Na2CO solution means 20 grams of Na2CO3 is present in 100 ml of solution. Similarly, volume to mass percentage, same manner. Next one, strength of solution. The strength of solution is defined as, it is very, very important one of the method to express constant of solution. Strength of solution. The amount of solute, the amount of solute in grams the amount of solute in grams present in 1 liter of solution. Liter of solution. It is very important method to express the concentration of solutions. The amount of solute in grams present in 1 liter of solution. 1 liter of solution means strength of solution is equal to weight of solute by in grams, weight of solute by volume of solution. Here, don't think that it is a weight by volume percentage. It is not the weight by volume percentage. Weight by volume percentage, nothing but what? Weight of solute by volume of solution into 100. But the strength of solution, nothing but the weight of solute in grams by volume of solution in terms of liters. In terms of liters. If you want convert into milliliters, multiply by 1000. Multiply by 1000. Suppose the same formula written as weight of solute in grams by volume of solution in ml into 1000. So that it is not the weight percentage, weight by volume percentage. It is only strength of solution, weight of solute by volume of solution in ml into 1000. Here, the units of the strength of solution, units, nothing but gram, liter, inverse. Gram, liter, inverse, otherwise, are gram per decimeter cube. Gram per decimeter cube means 1 liter equal to 1 decimeter cube. 1 liter equal to 1 decimeter cube, discuss later. It is a very, very important method to express the concentration of solution among all these. Strength of solution, the amount of solute in grams present in 1 liter of solution. So, strength of solution is nothing but the weight of solute by volume of solution liters. Similarly, weight of solute in grams by volume of solution in ml into 1000. The units of the strength of solution, very, very important, gram per liter, otherwise gram per decimeter cube, means 1 liter equal to 1 decimeter cube. PPM, nothing but parts per million, PPM, parts per million. 1 million is equal to 10 power 6 or 10 lakhs, parts per million. Whereas PPB, parts per billion. Here 1 billion is equal to 10 power 9. It is very, very important method to express the concentration of solution. Generally, PPM and PPB we are expressing when the solute is very low amount. PPM or PPB is used to know the concentration of solution when the amount of solute is very low or traces. Otherwise, traces. ppm or ppb is used to know the concentration solution when the amount of solute is very low or basis when compared to the amount of solution or amount of solvent. The ppm or ppb you're using when the amount of solute is very low amount. How we are going to calculate the ppm and ppb? PPM parts per million is equal to mass of solute in grams by mass of solution in grams into 10^6 otherwise for gases the same definition for gas is ppm. PPM is equal to volume of solute that may be or number of moles volume of solute or number by volume of solution into 10^6 Similarly, PPB is mass of solute by mass of solution into 10^9 Both will be similar, only difference in the 10^6 mega and 10^9 giga. So PPM nothing but mass of solute in grams by mass of solution into 10^6 Otherwise, for gases, volume of solute by volume solution. Otherwise, it may be the number of moles, it is also R number of moles into 10^6 It is about the PPM and the PPB. It is one of the important methods to express the concentration solution where the amount of solute is very low compared to the solvent. Example, 10 ppm of SO2 in air. 10 ppm of SO2 in air. What it means? Means that indicates 10 ml of SO2 present in 10 ml of SO2 present in 10^6 ml of air. 10^6 ml of air. Here 10 ml of SO2, 10 ppm of SO2 means, in air means 10 ml of SO2 present in 10^6 ml of air. It's about the PPM and PPB. These are some different methods to express concentration of solution. Mass percentage, volume percentage, mass to volume percentage, volume to mass percentage, and mass to volume percentage, strength of solution, PPM and PPB. Now we are going to discuss some problems based on these. See the different problems which will be given in the IAT examination. Problems. Number 1. See that a research scholar A recent scholar has only 400 grams of valuable solvent and wishes to make it 20% of solute A. Okay, 20% of solute A. Calculate the mass of solute A. This is a rich scholar has only 400 grams of valuable solvent and wishes to make it 20% of solute A. Calculate the mass of solute A. This is very, very important. And coming to the formula method, simply we use formula method. The same problem we are calculated by using the formula method. Means mass percentage or percentage mass is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Percentage mass is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. See that percentage mass is equal to mass of solute by mass of solute plus mass of solvent into 100. Here already given as 20%. 20 is equal to mass of solute, you can take as x, by x plus the mass of solvent is given as 400. The mass of solvent given as 400 into 100. That is, it is only formula method. After completing this, we will explain the concepts method. So 20% is equal to, we take as the mass of solute method x by x plus 400. 400 is what? Mass of solvent into 100. By cross multiplication, 20 into x plus 20 into 400, 8000 is equal to 100x. From there, bring this 8000 is equal to 80x. We want only x, so that 8000 by 80. That means we have the 100 grams of solute A. 100 grams of solute A. It is based on formula method. The same formula we are using concept cell method. Means it is very simple method. Already the amount of solvent is 400. That has 20% solvent. Means what? 20 grams of A. In that case, 80 grams solvent. When the solute is 20 grams, solvent is 80 grams. But they are given as 400 grams of solvent. And how much solute we have only? Very simple. It is only constant method. We will not use the formal method. 20 grams of A, that gives us 80 grams solvent, because 20%. Here solvent taken as 400. How much of solute? 20 into 400 by 80. So that 8000 by 80 means 100 grams. Need not go for the formula. It is very very important method. Mass percentage. Now, one more problem. If the
Babu, problems and Mali cooks are chapter.
Same problem.
Problems and chapter.
What is it? Same diet of problem of the Bible. Problem diet of the Bible. The same problem repeating a research scholar has only 400 grams, 400 grams of valuable solvent. We have the 400 gram solvent and wishes to make it 20% of solution from solute A. Now calculate the mass of solute A. It is our problem. A research scholar has 400 grams of solvent. 400 grams of solvent we have. That wishes to make a 20% solution from solute A. Calculate the mass of solute A. Here I am explaining formula method. See that. Formula method. Just simply by using formula. We know that percentage of mass is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. The same formula we can witness mass of solute by mass of solute plus mass of solvent into 100. See that I'm writing here. The mass percentage of solute given as 20 is equal to, let me take as mass solute Bx by the mass of solute nothing but x. Already mass of solvent given as 400 into 100. Do the simple cross multiplication. Here 20 into x plus 400 means 20x. Plus 20 into 400, 8000 is equal to x into 100x. So from that 100x minus 20x, take 80x. So that 80x is equal to 8000. We want x. X is equal to 8000 by 80. So that 100 grams of A. It is based on formula. So that mass percent is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Mass of solution written as mass of solute plus mass solution into 100. Here mass percent is taken as 20. 20 is equal to mass of solute we taken as x. Whereas mass of solvent given as 400. X by x plus 400 into 100. means by doing the cross multiplication, 20x plus 8000 is equal to 100x. 100x minus 20x gives us 80x is equal to 8000. We want x, 8008 is equal to 100 grams. It requires a little bit more time by applying the formula. The same problem by using some concepts only. Simple manner. How it is? Here 20% solution of A, 20% solution of A, according to mass percentage definition, that means 20 grams of A as 100 gram solution. 20 grams of A as 100 gram solution. But we want solvent. 20 grams of A as 80 grams of solvent. Simple. 20 grams of A gives us 80 grams solvent. But here, how much solvent is given? 400. 400 grams solvent. 400 grams of solvent. That means how much amount of solute A. So they are simply 20 into 400 by 80. So that 20 into 400 by 80 means 8000 by 80 means 100 grams. Very simple. 100 grams of A. 100 grams of A. Generally, every problem has two methods. Formula methods and the concepts method. If you go for the formula method, it requires a little bit of time. And that means based on the by heart. Where conceptually, need not to by heart. Next, one more problem. If the, write the problem, if the legal limit of human exposure to carbon monoxide in the workplace, carbon monoxide in the workplace is 35 ppm. Assuming that the density of air in air is 1.3 gram per ml. How many grams of carbon monoxide in 1 liter of air at the maximum allowable concentration. This is once I will read the problem. If the legal limit of human exposure to carbon monoxide in the workplace is 35 ppm, the available carbon monoxide in the atmosphere is 35 ppm. This is assuming that density of air is given how much we have? 1.3 gram per ml. How many grams of CO in present in 1 liter of air at the maximum allowable concentration? This is the problem. Very very important problem based on the ppm, parts per million. And coming there, 35 ppm of CO in air. 35 ppm of CO in air. What it means? Generally, it nothing but 35 grams of carbon monoxide. 35 grams of carbon monoxide present in 10^6. 10^6 grams of air. This is the actual definition. Means what? PPM means the amount of solute present in amount of solution into 10^8, 10^6. So that 35 ppm of CO in air means what? 35 grams of carbon monoxide present in 10^6 grams of air. This is here CO we taken as a solute. This is nothing but solute. Whereas 10^6 grams per air nothing but a solution. It nothing but a solution. This is according to given data, density of air equal to 1.3 gram per ml. Whereas volume of air is nothing but 1 liter. Volume per nothing but 1 liter. This is density of air equal 1.3 gram per ml. Or gram per ml nothing but gram per liter also. Kg per liter also. It is also written as 1.3 kg per liter also. Both will be similar because 1 gram equal 10^-3 kgs, 1 ml equal 10^-3 liters. Both cancel. So 1.3 gram per ml nothing but 1.3 kg per liter also. Volume of air nothing but how much we have? 1 liter. Coming to the volume is equal to mass by density. Mass by density. Whereas mass of solution nothing but volume into density. How much volume taken as 1 liter? How much density we have? 1.3 kg per liter. Otherwise 1.3 grams we have only. So that here we have 1.3 grams of mass we have only. 1.3 grams. Okay, now we got the 1.3 grams of solution. 35 ppm means 35 grams of carbon monoxide solute present in 10^6 grams of air. Leave it. Coming to the density of air, 1.3 gram per ml. Whereas volume of air, 1 liter. Okay, now. So by converting this is volume, mass equal to volume density, 1.3 grams. Here we have come to this is 35 grams of carbon monoxide as 10^6 grams of air. Whereas what is the amount of air? 1.3 grams. 1.3 grams of air gives how much? We need to go for the formula. So that nothing but here we have the 35 into 1.3 by 10^6. By calculating this is calculate how much we have. 35 into 1.33, 15, 0 and 3, 5 and 5, 5 and 4. So 45.5 into 10^-6 grams. Otherwise 4.55 into 10^-6 grams without using any formula. Otherwise you go for the ppm is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 10^6. We get it. Already given by that 35 and mass solute we take as 35 grams and go for the mass of solution. By using this formula also we are going to calculate. But instead of the formula, the concept method is very, very easy. It is very, very important formula and also problem for the IIT JEE mains. Next, one more problem. Next, problem number 3. 20 milligrams of K plus ions. 20 milligrams of K plus ions are present in one liter of aqueous solution. 1 liter of aqueous solution. Density of the solution is the density of solution is 0.8 gram per ml. What is the concentration of K plus ions in ppm? That's the problem we have only. 20 milligrams of K plus ions are present in 1 liter of aqueous solution. The density of the solution is 0.8 gram per ml. Okay, now what is the concentration of K plus ions in ppm? Similarly, the given by ppm is equal to parts per million is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 10 power 6 we have. Mass of solute by mass of solution in 10 power 6. Here 20 milligrams of K plus ions present in means mass of solute means K plus ions is 20 milligrams means 20 into 10 power minus 3 grams. That is the mass of solute. Coming to the mass of solution means volume is equal to mass density, whereas mass is equal to volume density. And volume nothing but how much we have? 1 liter. 1 liter means 1000 ml. 1000 ml into density nothing but 0.8 gram per liter. So that we have the 800 grams of solution. So ppm nothing but mass of solute by mass of solution in 10 power 6, whereas mass of solute K plus ions given by 20 milligrams, 20 in 10 power minus 3 grams, whereas volume is equal to mass density, mass equal volume into density means 1000 into 0.8, 800 grams. Apply the formula ppm we have only. Mass of solute nothing but 20 into 10 power minus 3 by, here we have the mass of solution is nothing but 800 grams into 10 power 6 we have only. So coming to this is, here already 0 cancel, and 10 power minus 3 and 10 power minus 6 means 10 power minus 3, 2 by 4, already 10 power minus 10 power minus 4, and also one more 0, 10 power minus 10 power 3 we have, 10 power 3. means 2 by 4. 2 by 4 nothing but how much we have? 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 25. 25 ppm. So ppm nothing but mass of solute by mass solution in 10 power 6. The mass of solute nothing but 20 milligrams, 10 power minus 3 grams, 20 10 power minus 3 by here 800. And by simplification, 10 power minus 6 means 10 power 3. 250 ml. 1 by 4 means 250 ppm. Yes, sir. One more problem to understand the concept of the methods for the finding concentration of solution. Calculate the volume of solvent. Calculate the volume of solvent required. One solvent required to prepare. Required to prepare 20% volume by volume. 20% volume by volume. Solution. Using 70 ml of H2SO4. This is calculate the volume of solvent required to prepare 20% volume by volume of solution using method but using 70 ml of H2SO4. Calculate the volume of solvent required to prepare 20% volume by volume of solution using 70 ml of H2SO4. It is also, we can solve the problem by using formula, otherwise conceptually. Go for the conceptually, simple method. Conceptually. Here, 20% volume by volume. That means, 20 ml of solute. 20 ml of solute dissolved in 80 ml of solvent. We want solvent. 20 ml of solute dissolved in 80 ml of solvent. But here the solute amount is given. How much we have? 70. When the solute is 70 ml, of sulfuric acid, what is the amount of solvent? Simple. We need to go for the formula. Based on the volume percentage, 20% volume by volume means 20 ml of solute dissolved in 80 ml of solvent. Whereas 70 ml of H2SO4 gives how much we have only. So that 80 into 70 by 20. So 0 and 0 cancel. 56. 56 by 2 means 280. 280 ml. These are some problems based on the weight percentage, volume percentage, ppm like we have. Go for the one more problem. All these are very simple problems except ppm and ppb. Next problem number 5. Calculate the masses of cane sugar, masses of cane sugar and water to prepare 250 grams of 20% cane sugar, calculated masses of cane sugar and water to prepare 250 grams of 20% cane sugar we have only. Very simple. Here, amount of solution. Amount of solution is given by 250 grams. And under this is 20% of cane sugar. Means 20% cane sugar. 20% of cane sugar means 250 into 25 by 100%. Then nothing but 625 means 62.5 grams. It is the cane sugar. So that amount of sugar, amount of sugar is equal to 62.5 grams. And we want amount of water is nothing but total amount 250 grams solution minus of 62.5. So that 250 and 62.5, 5 and 7 and 8. So 187.5 grams of water. This is simple problems. All these problems to understand the concept, to how to apply the formulas and constant methods only. Thank you.